condolences to Kobe's wife. My superpower is the word. I blend the spelling with the music and the conjuring the curve. I'm a physically embodied demiurge. When the humanoid carving simulacrum is preferred. Father's body anatomically concurs with the body that a god would need to consciously observe. Arm, leg, 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 arm, and
to this day, to this day, to this day, to this day.
Bang, 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 bang. Bang, bang, bang.
To this day, bang, bang. To this day, to this day, to this day, to this day, to this day.
You don't find that suspicious. You don't find that suspicious.
Yeah, we hear. No fear. No fear. Yes, indeed. Yes, indeed. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, gods and goddesses, we are here. Another episode of Sacrilegious Sundays. This is actually episode number 7 for Like That. Featuring Brother Rich Phil, a.k.a. Rich Filth. A.K.A. Rich Filthmore, A.K.A. Brother Recto. I may be joined by some friends tonight. But tonight is a special night. You know what I'm talking about? It's the first night that we are in KTL Plus Studios. You know, new year, got a new look. You know what I'm talking about? Yeah, new bag. Yeah, new energy, you dig? Yeah, type shit. So this is a special day for us. Yeah, that's, yeah. This
bang,
is,
bang.
We got sound
bang,
effects back.
Bang.
So the bombs is back, baby. The bombs is back. The bombs is back. So you know, media is everything. You know what I'm talking about? New media is something that we have been the vanguards of, me and my brother Blue Pill, even before these YouTube days. I mean, going way back to Four Corners and all kind of things. Like, we've been on the forefront. So we're about to take our network, right? Very vast network, might I add, because your network is your network. But we're about to go into this new paradigm, this Web3 decentralized streaming paradigm, you know, because the days of YouTube are somewhat numbered. You know? There's a whole new frontier, there's a whole new wave, there's a whole new airwave, there's thousands of different platforms. Yeah. Arriving and arising. And you know, you have the opportunity to put your content wherever you please. And with the rise of artificial intelligence and other autonomous and automated services, you can actually get these things done, you know, smarter and not harder. You feel me? So the future that people talked about, wrote about, spoke about, you know, and all of these other things, that future is here. We are in that future. We are currently, presently, in not the last days, but the days that, you know, the days that we've been all waiting for. You feel me? We here. You feel me? And every day that goes by, not a day passes since 2024 started, that you're not being reminded of the fact that this is a year that you should not waste any moment of. You should take full advantage of every single moment of this calendar year right here, 2024, where nothing is promised, but everything's for certain. You dig? And one of the things that we made sure that we're gonna do is we're going to, we're gonna tap into the what nature is calling for, because you know this is the new year. So for the new year, I'm popping out. I'm talking about, I'm gonna get the sound right, I'm gonna get the audio, I'm gonna get the video, I'm gonna get three cameras. Yeah, I'm gonna get the setup. We're gonna launch the studio. We're gonna go all the way in. We're gonna pop out, because winter time is a time to hibernate. And this winter was brutal on everybody that I know. So if I use the law of averages, I could just say that everybody was getting their ass served to them. But this is the great reset. And you about to see a whole bunch of resetting. You know, you about to see the great reset. Hold on. Hold on.
You don't find that suspicious.
I'm just saying.
You don't find that suspicious.
You don't?
You don't find that suspicious.
Don't you? I mean, everybody is picking sides. All of the boards are being reshuffled. The deck is being reshuffled. The cards are being reshuffled. We good? Well, how are we on the audio? Okay, I'm going to chill until we get it right. To everybody in the building. It's a new year. Happy New Year. We outside. Play some music. So they can't hear. Turn the sound off. Huh? Hey, Dave. You turned the sound off? Waiting for the bell to ring. I'm fighting temptation and put the spell on.
Now I just pulled up on everybody from last year cancellation. Like, fuck all you niggas. Fuck.
Did you know that Israel has been using Gaza as a testing ground for robot dogs? These highly mobile, agile, and semi-automatic robotic dogs are worth $165,000 each. They have multiple sensors that help them recognize objects and people in low...
The venue. At least 115 people are...
Yeah. All right, I'm live right now. I'm gonna have somebody come and get you. We good? All right, check that. Turn this off. Jeff is outside. Peace, peace, peace. We back? We good? Let me know how we sound on the audio. Let me know how we sounding on the audio.
To this day! To this day,
bang, bang.
To this day,
you don't find that suspicious. You don't find that suspicious.
Let me know how we sounding on the audio. So was it that moment or was the audio bad the whole stream? Come on, what are we doing? Are you sure?
Huh?
It was low. All right, so allow me to reintroduce myself. You know what I'm talking about? Hold on.
Bang, bang.
You didn't tell me
bang,
I was, yeah.
Bang,
to this
bang,
day.
Bang, bang.
You don't find that
to
suspicious.
To this day.
You don't find that
to
suspicious.
This day.
You don't
to
find
day.
That suspicious.
to this day.
Audio mean everything, to baby. This day. You know what I'm talking about? But yeah, we here. Happy New Year. We back. You know what I'm talking about? Yeah, KTL Plus Studios. We in this thing, you know what I mean? This is Sacrilegious Sundays, episode 7. You know what I mean? Called Like That, featuring your brother Rich Phil, aka Rich Phil. Yeah, we got Bang. The sound. We in the building, man.
To this
yeah.
day, you don't yeah. find that suspicious.
It's a whole.
To this day. Find that suspicious.
Yeah, so to let's get day. Right back into it. Like to I said, day. The Great Reset is what we're witnessing these days. Everything is being reset right in front of your very own eyes, all the way down to the world of entertainment that people like to call entertainment, but we will call not just entertainment, but hip-hop is identified as a divination system. Hip-hop is identified as the driving force of the culture. Hip-hop is identified as the master egregore that is responsible for how the children, the adults, and even at this point, the grandparents and some of the great-grandparents think and whatnot. It is highly impressionable, right? So there's been a reshuffling. A great reset is taking place in hip-hop as we speak. Well, I think it already has taken place. And the reshuffling of the deck, as you can see, for everybody that's into, because, you know, some people, they listen to bluegrass and whatnot, and they be off the grid, right? I don't do Spotify. Yeah, all right, whatever.
To this day.
Suspicious.
To this
you don't
day.
Find that suspicious.
You don't to this find
day.
It.
You know? To this day.
They active. They outside. You know, pick a side is what I'm hearing people say these days. And what you see people who used to be clicked up with before moving forward as this great reset is resetting things, you ain't gonna never see that again. Them days is over, Hova. You know, because one thing, you know, it just comes a time when you gotta pick a side. You know what I'm talking about? And as you can see with this conflict that's going on overseas and whatnot, since October 7th, it has caused a lot of people to pick sides and whatnot who necessarily wouldn't be on those sides. Like, nobody could have told me in a bingo contest that Candace Owens would be fired for making anti-Zionist statements, right? And standing up for the right side. Hold on.
You don't find that suspicious. You don't find that suspicious.
You don't find it.
You don't find mm. that.
Now I just pulled up on everybody from last year cancellation. Like,
did you know that Israel has been using Gaza as a testing ground for robot dogs? These highly mobile, agile, and semi-automatic robotic dogs.
Okay. How we doing? So when we come in, I'm going to bring...
Yo.
All right. Peace, family. Peace to you and yours. All right.
Peace.
Peace, peace. We are joined here by the good brother Jefferson is in a building.
Bang, 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 bang.
Peace, good brother Jefferson.
Peace.
How
peace
are you?
To the KTL world. Know the ledger.
Yes,
back
indeed.
Again, two
yes.
nights in a row.
Yes.
We're streaming.
Not only are we streaming, but we locked in.
Locked in.
March Madness.
March Madness.
Locked in. I told people that I'm doing a bid in the content house. They don't understand. I'm like, nah, I'm really locked in. They like, I'm doing Ramadan. I'm like, I'm doing a bid. Locked in.
This is the streaming Ramadan.
Streaming Ramadan.
We gave up sleep.
Gave it up.
Yeah.
Yeah. Making content in our sleep. I'm talking about literally content is cooking these days. Content is like being at the stove.
Yeah. Start screaming like ack.
You can have two elbows like Auntie Patti LaBelle in them and cook up some pies and whatnot with some fire content. Real talk. You could serve mad different customers because you could now take content that was made in English and run it and translate it into what? 40, nah, 50, 80, 100 more, 120, yeah, 120 languages, that's right. And you could send it to each one of them countries. Nah, what you mean? Around the world, huh? You could send it around the globe. So possibilities are endless just with that cheat code right there for people that like playing video games. Well, here is a little heads up. Right now, type shit, life is like a video game type shit. This AI and this technology, it's creating cheat codes and life hacks, brain hacks, you know, just the hackathon. It's giving Big Hackington. Yeah, it's giving Big Hackington. So what's good with you, good brother?
Yeah, I'm just here for the live stream to get live, to get into this world of YouTube, Twitch, and speak my piece. You know, hear some good commentary, comment on some good things.
Did you say YouTube just now?
You know, YouTube's still rolling.
It is.
Are we YouTube killers?
We not the YouTube killers, but we streamers now.
Oh, we streaming.
It was all a stream. I used to read Word Up magazine.
I used to read the source.
Hi, Benzino. Hi, Benzino. Hi, Benzino.
Rap Elvis.
Hi, Rap Elvis. I
you don't find that suspicious.
Yeah. Okay, okay. I'm saying.
He did the whole video in Eminem restaurant.
That part. Mama spaghetti. But listen, you know what I'm talking about? What I'm saying is. We outside, man. Did y'all see this poster right here? Check this out, ladies and gentlemen. This is Melanin Monday, right? The legendary series that we've been doing in Atlanta. Legendary Melanin Mondays IRL. You dig? Where we've been turning our legendary series into a live experience. And now we are in the studio turning our quote-unquote podcast experience into a streamer's experience, because we're streaming now. We're not on YouTube like that. We're in the streaming realm. You feel me? And we're tapping into a whole nother audience and a whole nother niche. And the upgrade is giving taxes must have hit early. It's giving. Giving. Next up, the veneers, nigga. It's giving. You know? Lights are back on. You know what I'm talking about? Sound is back. You know what I mean? You know, engineers are back. You know, mine got the full package. You know, Kamala was in Atlanta, right?
Lights, camera, action.
Yeah, she was leaving stimuluses. She came with her Tim stuck. What happened?
To this day.
They what? Are we on Twitch, man? Is a dope fiend twitching?
Give him the Twitch channel.
Mm-hmm.
Red Pill 44. Red Pillar 44.
Red Pillar 44.
Yes, sir.
On Twitch.
On Twitchington. Yeah, let's run up those Twitch numbers.
Yeah, we need to hit 80K. A minute.
It's a hard night.
Like Kai Cenat.
That part.
Yeah.
You feel me?
A minute.
And I won't consider myself a modern gamer because I'm a classic gamer, meaning that I had Gyromite and I had the gun on the screen playing Duck Hunt.
Right.
Close. Feel me? Close.
Never miss,
boy. Got to round 100.
Excite Bike. Remember Excite Bike?
Remember Tecmo Bowl?
Oh, yeah. Double Dribble.
Ha-ha. The legend.
Double Dragon.
Mike Tyson Punch Out. But listen, yeah, we're going to talk about Mike, too, on his Sacrilegious Sunday. Let's get right into Mike, matter of fact. What a segue. First of all, shout out to Mike. Mike is a legend for many reasons. One of the main reasons that I would say Mike's comeback story is one of the, it's like a Brooklyn fairy tale. You know what I'm talking about? It's reading like a Brooklyn hero's journey. It's a story of redemption. It's a story of rebranding. It's a story of rewiring. It's a story of, a reemergence. Because he hit rock bottom.
Yeah. At one point.
Huh?
At one point, you were like, Tyson done.
Super done. To the point where he wasn't even mentioned in the conversation of a lot of young generation's top five. They were not even considering Mike Tyson. Ferocious Mike Tyson, the knockout tapes that you see on YouTube and all of that, you know, the whole reel of they wasn't, the younger generation don't even know that part of Mike, bro.
Right. I remember watching HBO when you didn't have to do pay-per-view. His fights used to come on HBO. He knocked out dude in like 30 seconds.
They used to end on HBO real early too. Before we laid out the popcorn.
Right.
Where the popcorn at? Yo, before this bag right here was halfway gone, pull the popcorn out.
Look.
Yo,
We can't even crack it.
We can't even crack it, yo.
He had knocked the nigga out.
By the time it was cracked, it was over. Spent all of that money on beverages. So Mike was known for cleaning niggas up real early and whatnot. And then they took him down in Indiana and was over. Railroaded the gourd. You know what I'm talking about? Like Nas said, he headed down to Indiana. Yeah, that red and blue pill strain is coming on 420, right? This is an early announcement. That red and blue pill strain is hitting real hard. We made sure that we lived with it for about a month before we put it on market. But yeah, thing right there. That thing right there is responsible for a classic album.
But I'm here to bear witness that it's smoke.
Say that again now, brother. Hold on.
You don't find that suspicious.
Hold on.
You don't find that.
You gonna get this work.
Say that again.
It's smoke.
What's smoke?
KTL. Delta 44.
Oh, for show. You feel me?
Yeah.
Big smoke, man. You know, it's giving what it's supposed to give, especially in these days and time where reports are coming out that there are traces of Fetty Wap on the, Buddington, right? So that poses a very, very, very dangerous precedent. You feel me? Like, right. Imagine going to get an L and your ass take an L.
So, that's, You gotta be cautious these days. Make sure you go to a trusted personnel. Don't go to nobody new.
Man, listen, you. My thing is this. At this point, you gotta tap into people that you literally know, right, who got it and who has it legally. We not pushing nothing that we can't stand on. It's all legal, because I'm not touching nothing with the illegal part to it. You don't have to. People are throwing their shit away, and they if they put all of that energy into steering in a private, in a more thoughtful direction, you know what I mean? If they use those brain cells to build an empire in 30 days, 60 days, 90 days, you know, people spend years putting together a criminal organization or empire or some type of terrorist organization. Right. Oh, by the way, if you go to Russia and you are LGBT, my guy or gal, you're a terrorist. I didn't say it. Putin is shooting. That's what he said. Talk black to me.
All right. Straight
out. He said this.
A whole statement.
Let me work. Please, let me work.
He told niggas in Jamaica.
He about to get this work.
He told Capleton, Sizzla and them. He told Buju. He told him.
You gotta get this work.
Says, just chill. Just chill.
Now I just pulled up on everybody from last year canceling. He's like,
bang, bang, bang.
Suspicious. You don't find that suspicious. You don't find that suspicious.
They come enemies upon the borderline. Enemies. I would love to read his white paper. Like, what does that court case look like? The one that made him ban and call the LGBT a terrorist organization. That needs to be talked about. Listen, there's some shit going on in Russia today. Shout out to Putin for shooting, because they had the best week ever. Like, American press don't want to give it up, but that's why we have sacrilegious Sundays, because we about to get sacrilegious with it. Look at what happened in Russia in the past few days. Let's go down the timeline. Vladimir Putin swept the presidential, before he did that, his top op, the person who was his biggest political threat, right, met his demise, right, whilst in custody and whatnot, right? He's known for, being Mr. Cleanup.
He got killed in jail?
Something like that. When the Putin shit hit Netflix, he gonna be a legend. But right now, y'all can judge him. But anyway, hold on. When that Putin series hit Netflix, y'all gonna be on his tail. He's gonna be Team Putin, right? But now he the bad guy. But look, he knocked off the other dude from the Wagner Group, big op, top op. You know what I mean? That was NBA Young Russia out there doing a lot of, he was putting in a lot of pain and whatnot. And Putin took him out. So now he has a landslide victory and whatnot. And then he has a press conference where he does something that literally shook the pillars of what you call the Matrix, because the Matrix is built off of the quote unquote me and Blue Pill and others, especially the Moors. And then Europeans and other scholars have talked about the doctrine of discovery and the fact that this reality that we exist in right now is built off of the crown and also the church. And that would be the crown of King Isabella and King Ferdinand. And the church will be the holy, it would be the Holy See. And that's the Roman Empire, right? That's the Roman Catholic. That's Babylon, right? That's the Vatican and all of them. And their reality, or the perception of the reality that they built this whole thing upon, is a remix, right, of a story that was originally about an original man, right? So Vladimir Putin, who represents the Greek Orthodox Church, that doesn't have, they already are part of the, they were part of the Great Schism, or the, you know, the separation, where the Roman Catholic went their way, and then they went, and then they went their way, and they, right, that Greek Orthodox side of things, they represent a different depiction of Christ, or the Christos, or the Christos Negroes. So he revealed to the world, because keep in mind, just because Americas are not tuned in, the world, if you look on these maps, is very large and whatnot, it's humongous. And Russia is at the forefront of these world politics, geopolitics. You know, they a lot of people listen to what they have to say, and their influence is enormous. And it just grew. It just grew in size, right? With this act, or this monumental act that this that Vladimir Putin did, he revealed the treasures, or he revealed the quote unquote. Can you pull that up? Is that possible? Could we pull up Vladimir Putin reveals the black, Christ?
He did a whole speech on that.
Did a whole.
He basically said, "Welcome in Africans."
You feel me?
Anybody African, we need y'all to lift our country.
The skeeter is skeeting, right? And he's gonna catch the ears of many of the Africans, a lot of people who, you know, they'll listen to what's being said by that man, right? So immediately after this revelation was made, and this declaration was made, and, you know, they'll show you when they open up the tombs and whatnot. Remember, they used to have us take off school. It's a half a day because they're going into the tombs, right?
They found something.
It was like,
it was already there.
Right, right. We didn't even realize, wait a minute, they're going into somebody's graveyard?
Right.
So they didn't tell us about this, though.
As the Ukraine-Russia war drags on, Russian President
Vladimir Putin has decided to move made an announcement about the Christ being melanated.
Nobody saying nothing. The Pope, nobody.
Not a bird. So immediately after that, the propaganda kicks right in, right? Or the operation goes right into response, or the matrix kicks right in, and a terrorist attack occurs on their soil the first time in a very long time. In a very, very long time, right? And this attack took place against the Christians there by so-called rebels that they, not anyone else, but what Western media identified as ISIS. But as so many people on social media pointed out, ISIS is also the acronym for the Israeli Secret Intelligence Service, okay? So when they say ISIS took responsibility, you have to pay attention to the use of words that they're using. This is propaganda at its highest. So now when they talk about Russia in the news, they're only talking about that attack. They're not talking about the fact that the revelation of a melanated Christos, a Christ-like, a Christ, Jesus the Christ. It's showing it? Okay. Is this from another day? Does it show the date?
Pull up what he said. Can they hear it?
Read this.
Музеи устроены все условия, прежде всего климатические, таким образом, что там все экспонаты в полной безопасности. То есть там им устроена, вы знаете, максимальная среда, когда вот больной, например.
The historian taunted how the Russian leaders over centuries have turned to icons in tough situations with the hope of victory.
Церкви сейчас совершенно новый уровень авторитета. И если церковь о чем-то просит, скорее всего, что ей не могут отказать, потому что после 24 февраля у нас настолько все поменялось, да, и сейчас у нас абсолютно новая согласованная политика государства и церкви.
Even though the Russian historians are opposing this transfer order, the church seems to be in support of it. The church has said that the required controls will be provided at the Moscow Cathedral. Tretyakov staff will also supervise the artwork during its stay. Video report, Vion, World is One.
More recently, let's put Putin and put Black Christ.
Give me 30 seconds, I'll make you 20% more on your e-commerce, TikTok, and Facebook ads. Actually, it'll only take 10 seconds.
Were Jesus Christ, his mother, the Virgin Mary, and his people black or white? This has been a long debated question. Europe has always tried to depict Jesus as a fair white man with blue eyes, long blonde hair, and tall height. This was further strengthened by paintings from the 15th century. Where Jesus appeared much like a typical European man. But does this prove Jesus was white? Well, not necessarily.
Just type in Putin holding the icon. The fourth video right there, is that it?
The top, right there.
The one on the top?
As the Ukraine-Russia war drags on, Russian President Vladimir Putin has decided to move one of Russia's holiest icons from a museum to a Moscow cathedral.
That's it.
Icons dating back works of art. Before then, they were mainly viewed as religious objects, often left blackened over the centuries by the passage of time and added layers of paint.
That was when they said Putin opens vault right there, reveals black biblical.
What Jesus looked like. There are no known images of Jesus from his lifetime. And while the Old Testament kings Saul and David are explicitly called tall and handsome in the Bible, there is little indication of Jesus' appearance in the Old or New Testaments. In addition, when Jesus was arrested in the Garden of Gethsemane before the crucifixion, Judas Iscariot had to point Jesus out to his soldiers among the disciples, presumably because they all appeared similar to one another. But the words of the Bible in itself did not hint on the reasons behind their similarities. Whether they were white or black, or why or how they looked too similar, it did not.
As you can see, you see why they want to get rid of TikTok, right? Because YouTube is literally scrubbing and censoring and not letting real shit come on a network like that. And TikTok literally is flooding the airwaves with the realest of realest stuff. It's crazy that that's the case, but that damn sure is the case. Please believe it. I don't really even be on TikTok like that. They might have to start cutting these shows up, or maybe some classic Red Pill. And fill in and start sprinkling it on a fertile TikTok soil. You know? But yeah, how we doing? We good? Yes, yes, yes. Okay. Yes, indeed. So yeah, man. What's good, Jeff?
I was trying to check to see if I could find that video. But nah, it's okay. You know what's up, you know? Putin basically he said bring the blacks on through. You know, right. In other words, you know, he was giving reverence cuz all the pictures that they pulled out was basically just old paintings of you know, priesthoods of blacks. Everybody was dark skinned. And he acknowledges it. Right. You know?
Right.
I'm just trying to see if I can find that clip.
Right. And if we don't find it tonight for Melanin Monday, which we will be broadcasting from KTO Plus Studios. We will definitely have, because I got it in my keynote and whatnot. I got a whole slide of everything. So fret not, worry not. You'll see it tomorrow. But make a long story short, Russia, who is currently the dominant force in Africa, maybe not America, but definitely Africa, Central Africa, and other places and other nations and whatnot, very instrumental, very influential. And when the rest of the, what they call the third world, which is currently becoming the first world, because a lot of them got Bitcoin and a lot of crypto, been stacking that shit for a very long time.
El Salvador,
you know what I'm talking about? That's legal tender, huh?
Might be a move right there.
You dig? Yo, I know that I had a follower from El Salvador and whatnot, and my DM, nah, I'm gonna stop. But El Salvador is lit because the biddy is legal tender. And they get money in El Salvador too. You know what I mean? It's 100,000 gang members locked up. So somebody is out there bubbling.
Right. The underlings didn't go anywhere.
Right.
They didn't go to school.
You feel me? And then remember the whole Silk Road and everything. The whole I got bros in Atlanta. I got scammers in Atlanta. All of them niggas, they was on, they had biddies and whatnot. That was a Bitcoin party. So, you know.
It's the full moon.
Yo, the moon is lit. Super full. You see it? I could
blowing
feel
out
it.
There.
Blowing. It's
Did
glowing.
Y'all see it outside?
Did you see it?
Find that suspicious.
Did you see it?
You don't find that suspicious.
Moon banging.
You don't find that suspicious.
Moon banging, moon glowing. That aura is strong. Make sure y'all put your intentions out there. You feel me? I'm going to play that Future album all night and just vibe out. I might take about 3 Grizz Nams. He said all his shorties is on shrooms.
Yeah, he did say that.
I was talking to my peoples yesterday. Raven was here, and we were reflecting on a experience that we had where I was hosting the conference called DMT, right?
Yeah.
Before Cat in the Hat came with Dark Matter Tour, we had a series called Dark Matter Timing with A.A. Rashid, Blue Pill. This was in 2020 in ATL. So yeah. I came down from the East Coast, and I was in Buckhead and whatnot, and Billionaire PA, he had the dope condo in one of those luxury buildings and whatnot. So we decided to do some shrooms, right? We did some shrooms because we got blessed with a pack and whatnot. So we did some Golden Teachers, and I remember feeling like, yo, I had the conversation when we was on the Boomies. I'm like, yo, this shit'll be crazy. We in Buckhead.
You don't find that.
Yo, CapGPT. Who gonna make that? CapGPT, nigga. We need CapGPT. You know what I'm talking about? Right. This is foolproof chat. This is CapGPT. Cause I ain't even, I you know what I'm saying? I forgot he was there. So I could have been Cappington. But he's, yeah, he know.
Luxury. Plush.
Matter of fact, yeah. Like I'm putting nobody's name out there, but somebody else lived there. So,
right.
I'm like looking over the city, you know what I mean? Feeling real litty and whatnot. Where I was making, that's what I started making a classic album, Red Summer, off of that experience. And I'm like, yo, it'd be crazy if this whole city was on the Boomies, y'all.
Shout out to Mama Sauce.
Shout out to Mama Sauce who kicked it off, you know what I mean? AA, I went to go see AA, and Mama Sauce was like the Matrix when Shorty when the bunny pulled up you feel me, or like when Trinity low key Trinity. When Trinity pulled up, no just yeah Mama yeah, Sauce, Trinity. The executive producer of Red Summer, when she, that was Trinity vibes. Mm-hmm. She came with that flavor. And we made classics. And we was on the Boomies heavy. And we was like, yo, it would be crazy if the A was on the Boomies. Fast forward.
Bang, 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 bang.
To this day.
In the Rari.
To this day.
If I had a dollar for every time I heard it in one of these new rap songs, fam. You understand?
Yeah. The thing now.
Man.
Natural medicine abuse.
I called it sideways. I call it left-handed healing. Mm-hmm. For the people on the left-handed path, they heal left-handedly too. I'm left-handed and I'm naturally left-handed, and then I'm left-handed too. So left-handed healing is where you gotta drink the Casamigos and take the shrooms at the same time. Right. You say fuck it. Yeah. You can't go all the way in. You can't get all the healing, but you're gonna get some of it though. You feel me?
I'm doing better than he doing.
I'm doing better. So one of the things that make me happy is that I know certain people who I came up with, grew up with, I'm seeing them evolve, and I'm seeing them having ego deaths, and I'm seeing them dressing like hippies and whatnot. I'm seeing them, you know, wearing, they wearing bell bottoms. They looking like the 70s and whatnot. But not just in look, though, but they're adapting it in their minds as well, because the hood is on shrooms. So there is no negatives to that. You can't pull negativity into that. It is what it is. Oh, they drink. No, don't judge. Nigga.
Better than crack.
You understand?
Better than heroin.
Better than weed at this point, because of what you don't know, bro, you know how much air I smoked out here in the A? The reason why we had to get our own growers. Smelt like it. Looked like it.
Not it.
We're talking about THC with BBLs, bro.
Custom fitted.
No, a lot of atoms with just air in it. You know what I'm talking about? I'm smoking air, bro, not gas. Mine is smoking air in it.
Suspicious.
I'm like,
you don't find that suspicious.
I'm hitting that shit.
You don't find
smoking it like a Newport. Ain't nothing coming back.
CBD.
It was like my crypto, it was like crypto when I went through the bear market. Right. I was throwing everything at it. Ain't nothing coming back, bro.
Buying all kind of 1 cent coins.
You feel me? I'm in a gym, man. We getting our lick back. There's someone, nigga. Get ready. The crypto bros is coming like the Moors in Spain. We getting our lick back. You feel me? For the shit we went through when it went to a bear market. We turned a cocaine bear market, it was. It was a cocaine bear market. It was brutal. Niggas was getting clawed alive by a bear. Imagine a bear on cocaine. I didn't even watch that movie. That should be mandatory, right? Yeah.
Maybe.
Shit crazy, man.
But you already know how a bear coming, so on cocaine, it's just another level.
Whole nother level. That's what it did to everybody's coins and their NFTs and their belongings and whatnot.
Ooh.
And, you know, now mine is Bach. You know? Shout out to Chicago Crypto Block Bully.
Shout out.
Oh, man. Shout out. Yo, one of the best to ever do it.
Definitely.
Me and the good brother have a special announcement for Patreons only, because we talk private with our members and we speak in the public about public things. And when it comes to private affairs, it's members only, right? But the brother has some very, very, very good news. We're going to be doing a follow-up that is, Monday? Maybe on Tuesday or Wednesday. All of my Patreons, just look out for that. You'll have inboxes and it'll be on the front pages too. But yeah, close that door. But yeah, man, shit crazy, man.
Yeah. I mean, they got a couple of things coming up too. You know what I'm saying? People should look out for.
Yes.
The classes, Akiba Line, right?
Oh, Yes, indeed. On April the 7th, y'all, the day before April the 8th, where everything is subject to change, right? Me and Akibalon will be bookending this whole cycle with a monumental presentation on Zoom only, right? Behind the paywall, because the things that we talk about, we can't talk about it in public. These are private conversations. So we put our private conversations behind paywalls and encrypted sites and whatnot. Vulture Culture. Vulture Culture, all right? Vulture Culture on April 7th. It's on the website, ktluniversity.com, and it's also on Eventbrite. So you can find it on Eventbrite. All you got to put in the search is Vulture Culture, and you can get your ticket there, or you can get it on ktluniversity.com. That is Akibalon 44, a.k.a. Akibalon the Dawn. The Dawn.
Definitely high level information if you're not tuned in. You don't want to raise your level.
He gonna get this work.
Akibalon always come with it.
As a matter of fact, not only does Akibalon come with it, but we did three series with Akibalon already over the course of about 2 years. If you were to revisit those series, right? Because that's where the real work, that's where the real proof of work is. That's where the real gold, where they say your data is gold and information and all of that is oil and what they mean is, if they go back into your content or into your stuff and you was out there predicting stuff, you don't know your own worth. It's the digital equivalent to pitching pearls to swine. You know? End it.
What happened? I guess the live ended. It got a time limit on it, or it's unlimited. Yeah.
Nah, it ain't unlimited. So, the equivalent to pitching pearls to swine, right, is not realizing that you already been putting out stuff that is worth a lot, proof of work. If you was on top of something before everybody else was on top of something, then there's a value in that. You know what I mean?
You put it in the air.
Right. Certain marketers.
You left it into the atmosphere.
Right.
Other people caught it.
Right. So it's important to know where the node begins. It's called a master node. Nobody's interested in a carbon copy. You got to give me the real, what's the source? What's the primary source? I don't want the clone. Somebody had come to it, the aliens come to America, the aliens popped up in the mall in Miami and whatnot. They was in a Tesla truck talking about they want to hear some new tunes and whatnot. They like, yo, who's the most lit person? Somebody said, Designer.
You don't find that suspicious.
Designer?
You don't find that suspicious.
And then another nigga be like, nah, Future. So then they say, nah, Designer. And then somebody be like, man, you off of your noodles, bro. You smoking that K2. It's Future. And they have to explain to them it's about primary source, not who's better, not who sound, none of that. It's about primary source, knowing who's primary source and knowing who's the clone, right? So that means everything.
Right.
So whoever sound like him don't mean nothing because they not him. It starts with him, and then everything that comes out of that.
Style got stolen.
Right, there you go. Clone.
But the clone usually never beats the original, usually.
Because they don't have the same code.
Right.
It's a clone. It never have the same fingerprint. It can never have the same. It's only a copy, a carbon copy. And the more you stretch out, the more weaker the gene gets. That's you see that in these unroyal families and stuff like that. You know?
Oh, your boy got cancer, right? Prince Charles.
No, he's not Prince Charles. He's King Charles.
King Charles.
He's Scorpion King, right, as a matter of fact. King. He's king of this whole shit because he's the king of Is It Real, bro? You got to remember the Balfour Declaration and what it is, what it actually means. Who bought that country? who is the one who benefited? And these people are the ones who was like, we ushering in our own state. And this is what we gonna call it. But, you know, that state belongs to a group of people. And he's the king of that. Because remember, they had a lot to do with that. And his power, he's the Scorpion King, born on my birthday. Right? Born on my birthday. The Scorpion King. And they said that they're not going to give him the chemotherapy. He's actually going the route of natural healing because he's into stuff like that. And I was like, wow.
Probably into everything.
He's into anything. I'm into adrenochrome. I'm into
science, natural medicine.
Yeah, yeah.
Exploratory medicine.
Right.
Robotics.
Robotics. First, you know what I mean? I need the Neuralink.
Send a link. Had that last year, 20 years ago.
Send the link.
I need something else.
Yeah.
You're going to try it out.
King Charles, the Scorpion Bot. Yeah. Then, the Wiz, who's supposed to be the queen.
Middleton.
Right. Because he got to abdicate, right? Because he got cancer in the it's like, you know, game over.
Right.
Right? So right behind him, a woman of a younger age too, and you looking at these royals, just to show you how the great divine speaks with signs, that even them side of Buckingham Palace that eat out of a garbage, whose immune system is way powerful than this nigga.
And with all the money in the world.
With all of that. They sitting on all of that stolen property. Where's loss prevention? Yeah. They loss prevention most wanted.
You don't find that suspicious?
All the riches.
You don't find that suspicious?
I'm in the Vatican.
You don't find that suspicious?
You know what I'm saying? I bet that lady who they bagged, the lady who was living in the mansion, who was ordering all of them people to go boosting and steal all of that stuff from Sephora, right? She's probably related to Buckingham Palace, huh?
Fake address.
Fake address, right. She probably related to Buckingham Palace. I bet any amount of money. You know what I'm talking about? That whole strain from that family, they just go and boost a lot of shit out of a lot of people's countries. And they serial thieves, y'all.
They show it off, too. Like, look what I took.
And they floss it, too.
And y'all can't take it back. You're going to jail.
You stealing, going, right.
Because I stole it from you.
And a lot of people that live in, like, the Caribbean, and a lot of people that live in places like the continent and other places, when you see them British people who come and flaunt shit in you, you can't, or them French who arrogant with they shit and they taunt you and they floss on you and they flaunt on you and they can get you knocked off and you can't do nothing. Shit like that is like, you know.
Of the president of France, Marco, right? That's his name?
Yeah.
Yeah, they was burning that in Africa.
Yeah, yeah, they fed up with him, boy. You know what I'm talking about?
Yeah, he getting tossed out of all them countries.
Yeah, it's time to pack it up season. They packing them up.
Out of here.
It's literally a revolution taking place on the continent, and people is talking about, yo, what's up with these migrants, right? Mm-hmm. It's literally a revolution taking place where they telling the people, y'all got to go home. You know what I'm talking about? We're taking our what it boils down to, they like, we want our resources. What the Haiti shit boils down to, when you listen to what they saying, they like, we want our resources. We don't want nobody running our resources because it ain't no reason why. We got TikTok. Niggas got water. They got water, heat, and electricity. They got Louis and Gucci. I went to Saks.com, and the shit is $5,000. That's what the Haitians are saying. If they buying shit like my Haitian brothers in America got all of this wealth. They popping bottles. They lit. We don't got water. So they like, nah, y'all got to go. What's going on? is lit. Hold on.
Bang, 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 bang.
The brother in Burkina Faso was like, yo, the old administration gotta go. Cause y'all too, you know,
lax.
It's not just lax.
Hand in the pocket.
Not just hand in the pocket, right? It goes beyond that. It's like when you part of something, I call it a big detriment. A big detriment. A big detriment. It is. It's the Agent Smith myth.
Now I just pulled up on everybody from last year cancellation. It's like, fuck all you.
Theory, you know what I mean? It's that shit. It's the saboteur. It's the one who sabotages. It's Judas. You know? It always shows up. But it's giving P. Diddy, you know what I mean? It's giving no Diddy. You know what I'm saying? It's giving no Diddy because, you know, it's very zesty. It's giving Zest Fest. Yeah, it's definitely, it's giving Zest Fest. You know what I'm talking about? Giving Zest Fest.
You don't find that suspicious?
That's us, bro.
You don't find that suspicious?
That's us, bro.
You don't find that.
What's that about, Jeff? Yeah, man. Huh? You said what?
No diddy. What the chat said?
No diddy.
I just woke up, about to roll up. Hope I'm not too late. Fibonacci.
Oh, nah, you're not too right on time. We just getting warmed up. We outside. We outside.
Oh. Don't forget about 640 Cafe. I got Professor James Small coming.
Yes, we do. April the 9th.
King Simon.
King Simon is bringing Professor James Smalls to Atlanta.
Show off for that.
To the 640 Evan Streets. All right, YG Urban Cafe. Make sure y'all in the building. We have it on deck at the moment, but we will have it tomorrow at Melanin Monday, so you'll be able to see it. But you hearing it that Professor James Smalls will be in the A and the ATL on April the 9th in the West End. Pull up and show love and tap in with the family and, you know, come and get some content. You know what I mean? And come and meet some real life people in real life and, you know, come and tap in. You feel me? And then we also have the Malcolm X Fest coming up.
Yeah, Malcolm X Fest is in May. Malcolm X birthday. So that's a little ways away. Yeah. Start planning for the 420 release party. That's
definitely start planning for the 420 album release for the 48 Pillars of Power, featuring none other than yours truly, Red Pillar and Blue Pillar, known as the Twin Pillars, introducing our good brother, Andre 360 and whatnot. And this one right here, something that we are very proud to be standing on. This is standing on business, you know. Can we show the cover? This is definitely us standing on business. And, you know, getting back to the music and, you know, getting back to the art, though, for real, because that's really what it is. As artists, we have to express ourselves, and there's ways that we express ourselves, and we're not limited in our expression. And as master artists who've always been super duper talented, this is our gift, not only to ourselves, but to our family, to our future, to our progeny, to our bloodline, to our last name, to our hood, you know what I mean? To hip hop itself, to God Hop, you know, to everybody that's locked in and has something to do with this classic right here. But yeah, we did it with this one right here. This is the follow-up to Twin the album. So as you can see, 2024, it's all about the red versus the blue, right? This is a political year, but it's all about the red versus the blue. And in gangbanging, you see the red versus the blue prominently. That energy is very, very powerful and whatnot. But definitely the way that the politicians are gangbanging, this red and the blue thing is going to be very, very instrumental leading up the whole year.
The Olympics.
That pumps the
flag in the red, white, and blue to another level. So it's the even number years. They have a certain energy. The leap years have a certain energy with the red and the blue throughout the whole year. And the patrioticness, at least in the United States and America, that's hyped throughout the year.
Right.
You know, because of the political connection.
Climate is hot already.
You know,
yes, it's political theater, as we've spoken of on many occasions. But in that theater, is that climate is getting warmed up. It's heating up.
Yeah,
I would say that it's at a Fahrenheit. You know,
just wait till Trump name Candace Owens
as a running mate. Man, if that happens, we talking wipeout. I said it on the show before, all black media need, as if she's a free agent running around, all of the gossip and chatty patty fake Democrat shills, y'all on the chopping block. Cause she needs to go drill a few y'all. Mm. She's like Wreck-It Ralph. She's a necessary evil. You know what I'm talking about? She'll be a glitch. But she's smoking all of these people who are not really smart. They're kind of not even woke.
Right.
Like, you know, when you see the definition
she's not
of
going against anybody who has any steam for her.
Look, you can't stop Charleston White. You can't stop Candace Owens. There's a few people that y'all can't stop because they're standing on they're going against that principle, that blue wall that the people have, that we're not supposed to shame. We're supposed to be like, nah, you know, it's prison reform. We got to let the people out of jail. Yo, my mixtape, I'ma Kill Half You Niggas, is dropping at midnight. All right, peace to the streets. Stop the violence. Like, we ain't trying to live in this bipolar, you know, multiverse that, you know, you niggas is living in. Jonathan Majors running down New York streets.
Right. You know what I'm saying? Snow bunny disease, like Umar said. You know what I'm saying?
You doing the Cat Williams running challenge against a snow Becky. Like, what are you doing? What the fuck has New York turned into? You know what I'm talking about?
He might have learned his lesson.
And he damn sure did. He got with Megan Good. Jeez. He was like, oh, behave.
Should have learned his lesson.
I hope he did, bro. They washed my dude up.
The great big P said, I got a plan. I'm coming to AGL just to be on the KPL show.
You a legend if you pull up here, bro. This shit is going to be monumental right here. Take a good look at me. You know? This studio right here is going to be the site of some classic shit. You know, we back in our bag and whatnot. We've been very patient. And me and Blue have, you know, laid our groundwork. We did our footwork. Everybody around us, they done seen the work that we done put in behind the scenes, in front the scenes, around the scene, under the scene, to the side of the scene, seen the scene, you know. And now it's time to be seen. You know, on our Sarata Mustaquin, you know, on the Dean. Know what I mean?
Yeah.
Because this year right here is a monumental year and is demanding that you do some legendary shit. It's a lot of legends that didn't make it this far. This year is demanding that you do, we can't sit around lackadaisical. I'm not comfortable. I'm not comfortable.
Yeah.
You're
never comfortable.
Never fucking comfortable.
There's always a new
position. I'm wild uncomfortable, right. But right here in the studio, KTL Plus, oh nah, this is dreams fulfilled. And I did this with the support of my Patreons. I did this because there was a group of people, when they try to sink us and whatnot, and when they try to pull the plug on the gods, they soiled, they fed the fertilizer, and they helped this mycelium grow these shrooms and whatnot, these golden teachers. Yeah, Rich Phil, a.k.a. Golden Teacher.
The Boomingtons.
I think right. That's a whole album.
Yeah.
That's a whole album. Rich Filth, a.k.a. Golden Teacher. Volume 1.
Let me work! You gonna get this work, nigga? Watch me work!
Yeah, man, so... We outside on the south side.
Outside. Make sure y'all tap in, you know, to the drip. I know y'all think is available for sale.
Everything.
See this polo joint he got? We got a rendition of this coming out Kings County. That's going to make this one
look like nothing.
Come on now. I'm saying the vest. Corduroy vest.
Ralph.
They got that coming.
Yeah, all this.
You know, Kings County. Straight out the pack. So... anything we got on is available for sale. This Tubman joint, the vest, the shirt, you know, so the glasses for sale. Y'all hit us up in the DM.
Matter of fact, we about to launch this whole, we got this campaign because we're going to China to a trade show that actually lasts a month. And we'll have more information on that coming up. But we actually have some seats to go with us on this trade, on this, it's gonna be called China Flow, but it's gonna be one of the most eye-opening, monumental, entrepreneurial experiences that, we doing manufacturing and production at this point, and if people want to really, really get their brands into a place where they could scale it into ways that they could never imagine, especially with these multiple new economies that are sprouting daily almost, right? Let's just take a stab at about 4 new economies. You got the gig economy. I could do a whole month straight every day teaching a new lesson on ways to utilize the gig economy for that matter, depending on what they're doing. And then when the AI and a generative AI and the Midjourney and all of that drop, they started getting $100 and $500 an hour. So things are different based off of the gig economy. What you know is Uber, that's part of the gig economy. What you know is Uber Eats, part of the gig economy. What you know is Airbnb, part of the gig economy. You understand? People were able to monetize things that they were not able to monetize before and whatnot. The share economy, the gig economy. Then you have the creator economy. The fact that people don't have to, when you ask a group of children right now, if there's 10 children and you say, what do you want to be when you grow up? 7 of those children say they want to be a what? Content creator, huh? A content creator.
Bang, bang, bang. Make
money on social media. Content.
I need a light. That's not a bad thing. When you look at it, they want to create content. They want to be filmmakers. They want to be actors. They want to play roles. They want to be famous. They want to be known.
Country Wayne skits.
Country Wayne skits. They want to be silly, right? And no offense to none of the people that are on Instagram getting their money and going viral and whatnot. Get your money. Do your thing. However, what we used to look at with Saturday Night Live and what we used to look at with certain things like Living Color, They were funny and silly, right? Sometimes in this Instagram era or this TikTok era, it's just a lot of silly and not that much fun. You got to understand, you have to be able to distinguish. And you throwing them in with the funny niggas. And it's like, nah. Funny niggas, when we grew up, had like 4 movies under their belt and like 3 or 4 stand-ups, bro. See? They was out there burning shit down.
Who are you putting in your top 3 comedians?
My top 3 comedians of all time?
Yeah.
Richard Pryor. I got to put Bernie in there. And it's a cross between Dave Chappelle.
That's it. Three. You had another, you had an honorable mention.
I did. What's the honorable mention? Did I say Bernie Mac?
You said Bernie.
Yeah, Cat. It was the Cat was Williams. Honorable. Yeah. You know?
Well, I'm going to say Dave Chappelle, Martin Lawrence.
That would have been mine, too.
And I don't know. It's a toss between Cat Williams and Richard Pryor.
I would replace, I said Richard Pryor, right? I would replace Cat Williams with Martin Lawrence. That would be my Martin Lawrence because he did stand-up, he did the roles of acting, and he did movies. It would be facetious for me to not put him in there. Yes.
He had TV shows.
He had stand-up. And he was able to do what? There's a generation of children that don't know stand-up Martin. Don't know Martin Martin. They know Bad Boy Martin. They know rebranded action figure Martin. Mm-hmm. They like, what, Martin with the gun? Martin, they like, that's Martin. That's Marty Mar. And you'll have children arguing with you.
Right. Like, well.
You feel me?
Google it. Check the YouTube. I'm sure they got some skits, some videos.
Nah, if I gotta say check the YouTube, the conversation is over.
Anthem on the track.
Peace, family. You know G.C. and yours, brother Red Pill.
They need a time machine to take these youth on, like, some fucking, some history trips. So they could come back and have convos with us with right information about shit that happened.
You said the Bitcoin is accelerating the production of a time machine.
Man, it's coming. It's coming faster than you think. It's coming with that Blackwell chip that NVIDIA just dropped. That's going to bring the time machine on.
The quantum computer.
Yep.
D-Wave.
D-Wave. They're gonna ramp that shit up. Let me get some water, please. Yeah, so it's day two or three. No response from that light-skinned scorpion, Aubrey. Shout out to my...
He's going to release it on his next album. It's going to take 6 months.
We're going to get this work.
Nah, it don't work like that.
Suspicious.
But he with Wayne, though.
You don't find that suspicious. You don't find that suspicious.
He's going to go nuts, bro. That's what my son told me. He's going to go fucking Benoodles. He's with Wayne on tour. The battery that he needed.
Cole not on tour with him still?
Yeah, he Kendrick with a Hyugen, with a light-skinned Hyugen, with a Zionist Hyugen, then, you know, it'll be what it is. He had Khaled with him too. Come on now. You got all of the, yo, it was Team Fugazi. Yeah, it was a
hype team.
It was the hype team. All of
hype.
Yeah, all of Duracells was on deck.
You the go. We the best.
So whatever he needed.
Free Canada.
Huh?
I'm just here to watch. They're going to do what they do. I want to see what Cole going to do.
They said Ross picked the side. You know, the internet's loose, man.
Man, they got everything tipped and tagged as soon as something happened. Oh, okay. Why did this happen? Let me go digging. I got a story for my channel. And I guess that Gator reports these days. You know, they come with their receipts or they clamps or they programs they put on your account. How they got the clone accounts, all that shit still going on. You know, they don't let people monetize. It's wild. So, Twitch is the move.
You know who represents YouTube?
Who?
Academics. And you know who represents Twitch? Who? Kai Cenat.
I thought Academics is on Twitch too.
Doesn't matter. I'm talking about Archetype. I'm talking about Epochs and Eras. Yeah, put me on. 3 years ago, I was telling people about Aiden Ross and Kai Cenat because they were doing. And I was like, yo, my son put me onto this shit. These niggas got a crazy wave, bro. And they funny as hell because they're trolls. Because I understand internet language. You know what I'm saying? I understand culture. It's troll culture. People are like, oh, they wild zesty. Yeah, they're trolling. They're whole troll. They're akin to whole nations, whole continents.
That's true.
They was listening to the,
right.
So 90,000 people watching you at the same time while you listening to something. If you like, yo, this shit is super lit. Imagine that album going if you go at something 100 deep.
Right. Strong.
100 strong.
They paid to be on there.
What?
So they watching.
Huh?
I'm saying they getting all that money. Whatever they pay. They gonna watch. They gonna watch.
First club that. He doesn't care about the money anymore, right? That's not the business model of the record industry. That changed, right? Now they want your eyeballs. He said, I'll make you pay with your eyeballs, right? So they turned the business model into an attention economy business model. This is about retention. Selling ads and whatnot. The more you watch, the more they get paid. It don't matter what it is. If it's tragedy or triumph, it don't matter. It's still monetizable. And it's more than one way to skin a cat. So this thing is up. You know? It's up and it's been up. You know?
It's wild out there. It's wild out there.
Yeah, naturally. Rightfully so. You feel me? I would say rightfully so.
Wait, what's up with homeboy Baby Kia? What's up with homeboy Baby Kia?
Right. So when I talked about the aesthetic nihilism, right, I did the whole. We started up with aesthetic nihilism when we launched.
Song's the, fire, by the way. I do say that.
Right.
If I think back to me listening to Gravediggers,
horrorcore mixed with drill rap. Right. Horrorcore mixed with drill rap. Out of the whole bunch, I like him the most. Right. I remember when my son played Baby Kia for me. This was around Christmas. Right. First, he was playing the Drillers out of the Bronx with the thing bent, right? 41. It's something about the number 4 that all of these, they love 4, yo. Mm-hmm. But Blue said because it's because of death and war. But anyway, they play, his cousin DJ played Baby Kia, and I was like, yo, turn that up. We was all laughing. And I was like, yo, son is literally screaming, yo. Are you serious? Is this what they doing in Atlanta? And we laughed.
That's what they doing.
Fast forward. You know, I went down a rabbit hole because the research that I was doing on the aesthetic nihilism, and for anybody out there that's not aware what aesthetic nihilism is, the aesthetics, right? The way that we hip hop is the culture, right? Hip, you know, it's the way that we dress, it's the way that we carry ourselves, it's how we get down, it's our uniform, right? It's how our design language. Hey, D, it's the design language. Is how we put on, right? So the aesthetic of nihilism is the way that our people are showing up. Not just a few people, the culture. Not just the culture. If you go to Rolling Loud, the world. If you go to Rolling Loud, Portugal. If you go to Rolling Loud, Canada, Toronto. Rolling Loud, Miami. Rolling Loud, LA. Rolling Loud, New York. There's a whole world of people who have the aesthetic nihilism, quote unquote, ethos, right? They're attached to that egregore, gothic rap, right? Emo thugs, right? The fact that NBA popped up with his face painted and whatnot with the black nail polish, that's part of that whole opium movement. That's part of that Playboy Cardi movement. That's part of that gothic drill or gothic rap, or I would say horrorcore drill, right? The same thing that you saw, like you said, with the Gravediggers, right? This is a niche. This is a segment of rap.
Yeah.
South Park Psycho, I think, you know, but then it kind of fell off, you know, for a minute. From what I just fell into that bag and they put him there.
Nah. See, they got something called Crash Out. He's part of Crash Out culture. And that's Crash Out drill. So these little niggas is out here crashing out. Now, this is not something that I would want to celebrate, right? It's something that when I hear the music, I could feel the, it's a warrior spirit. I mean, you know what I mean? It's Crash Out shit. That's not something necessarily that you want to pour gasoline on. So, you know, they say what you give attention to, it grows and it expands. It's just of no coincidence. The minute I start checking this shit out, I turn around and just little niggas everywhere. You know what I mean? It took no time. He's everywhere. I'm like, oh shit. You know what I mean? But hip hop is the mythos. Hip hop is the divination system. Hip hop is that frequency. People would be like, oh my goodness. But that darkness, that you know, that raw DMX like, you know, Hell Is Hot like, Crash Out, you know, that shit is real.
Right.
We in them days.
And some niggas just got it off the mud.
Like that.
Everybody got it off the mud at some type of point.
Right. So shout out to Baby Kia, you know what I mean? And I want to see the young brother succeed. I don't want to see the brother, you know, he's interesting. Mm-hmm. He's interesting. But out of the whole movement, I checked all that out. I was like, nah, I see the potential. I would be a hater if I said so of this thing. So we have a different ear. We see things differently. But when you get the crash outs to crash out for you, then it makes sense. Because they're going to crash out for somebody. Yeah. So you might as well, you know, all the unks. Yeah, get all the unks. The unks step up, you know what I mean? The brothers, the OGs. You know, it's a lot of OG talk these days. They looking up to the OGs. They telling the OGs, you know, we want to hear what y'all, not just what y'all talking about, what y'all doing. Mm-hmm. So show these youth, because the Baby Kias, they will respond to real nigga activities. And they'll respond to real naga activity and real Negus activity before we judge them and throw them away. Because to be honest with you, they're like 18 and 17. I would be a goof troop if I was to judge a 17-year-old when we were literally out of our noodles at that age.
Right.
Bro.
Like teenage years is just
rough. It's the roughest.
You know what I'm saying? It's rough on the parents. It's rough on the kids. And so it's like you can't really be that hard, because is it that different from what you was doing?
If you came,
so it's like you just got to make sure they don't go up too far.
That's right. It's called a rites of passage. You know, these children eventually grow into responsible adults, but they got to walk through their hero's journey and on their path. You feel me? But I know when we were 17 and 18 and 19 and 20, we was on demon time. So I'm not making, you could basically intercept and show them a better way by not just judging them, but seeing the greatness in them. You know what I mean? Like they made a decision that they want to be here to you know, make a name for themselves and dip out. They don't want to be no old men doing life.
Put their music out, so they had some type of seriousness. And
feel me?
You put your heart into it, if nothing else. You know, so you put a video out, you're doing interviews, so you're going.
Right.
You know, did that.
Right.
You know, so
this is the underworld culture. This is the deaf culture. It went past the deaf culture. It's an underworld culture at this point. These kids are aesthetic nihilism. Nihilism, matter of fact, I didn't even get to that. Nihilism is basically you people questioning the purpose of life, living life meaninglessly, right? Questioning the death of God, right? That's the famously quoted. And then people who are into nihilism would be familiar with Friedrich Nietzsche or Nietzsche. I'll be hacking it.
Yeah. Well, yeah. Isn't it Germanic? German.
Yes, German. And a lot of the design language that you see in the young generation that are embracing like the rock and roll look, but not just the rock and roll look, but the symbols, you know what I mean? Right. And what the messages and the motifs are reflecting. Something that would make Bobby Hemmett, Azariah, Phil Valentine, Brother Dawood, and many other occult master teachers proud. Because they like, yo, they rock the skulls. You know what I'm talking about? They tapping into the darkness. Huh?
All the way in.
All the way in. Like not just playing with it. All the way in full character. They got the piercings in their face. Pinhead. They got the tats. You know, we always had the tats. We always had the piercings.
They just go another level. They just go a couple, three, four, five.
Just three, four, five. They different bosses Yeah.
They nihilists.
Right, you know right, so right. So
they go in a whole nother category.
Whole nother category.
Nihilism.
Yeah, they might be with the White Walkers and whatnot type shit. Right? Gothic, yeah. Right? Remember, emo thugs. Right? Niggas that kill you and got bangs. Huh? Yes. Look, new word.
That's the Avenger side.
Sassy aggressive.
You don't find that suspicious?
And the quarter.
You don't find that suspicious?
The president of sassy aggressive niggas. New activity. Sassy aggressive niggas. That's what we've been invaded by. Like, you remember Secret... the Scrolls.
Secret Scrolls.
Yeah, what was the name of that series?
On HBO?
Disney. Disney. It just came on Disney Plus.
Nah, I don't watch that.
It was Marvel. It's yeah.
Marvel 97, I saw commercials for that.
I know, but not that. I ain't watched that either. One. Yeah.
So you know I ain't watched Secret Scrolls.
Sassy, aggressive niggas have invaded and taken over, bro. That's what we being swarmed by.
I mean, the shit that I do catch... You know,
like you got dudes wearing fingernail polish that will smoke something. They riding for Omar from The Wire.
Yeah,
he's spawning a lot of niggas.
He's the progenitor.
he's
the noise.
He the Henrietta Lacks of this shit.
We gonna get this work.
This nigga's DNA lives on. He the Henrietta Lacks of this shit. Yeah.
Please let me work.
He the hella cell of this biatch.
To this day.
Yeah, he
to this day.
Yeah, this niggas is in the shadow of Omar. Mm-hmm. Sassy, aggressive niggas. These zesty niggas, the Zest Fest, will come to your city, shake shit up, bro. I'm telling you, you know, wear your vest. These niggas, you know, they invest in the Zest. You know what I'm talking about? Scary outside.
Nah, you still clear of that.
Yeah.
You know, you stay where you need to go and go to places that you're welcome.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and there's enough places like that in Atlanta. You know, you can come to Blue Black Wall Street, go to Tassili's, Dada.
Industry ATL.
Industry ATL.
Atlanta's a weird place. Atlanta's like multiple worlds. Atlanta's multiverses.
It definitely is.
Atlanta's a Rubik's Cube. You know what I mean?
You could literally live in one part and never go to no other parts your whole life, and that just be where you at.
I create my reality in Atlanta. I don't see nothing that I don't want to see. Like, literally. Facts. I don't walk into nothing. I don't, none of that shit happens. Like, I steer my boat, my Nebuchadnezzar, my GPS is on full throttle, you know? Shout out to the A, though. Shout out to the A.
Yeah, shout out to the A. You got Invest Fest back this year.
It's going to be a movie, yeah. It's time to, you know, once again, I don't want to put private conversations into the public, but there's gonna be a conversation about investment for the Invest Fest. So, you know, we'll have that behind the scenes with our Patreon. If you haven't joined the Patreon, do me a favor. Haiti. We're gonna play this Patreon commercial and whatnot. And if of the YouTube channel that we have for 15 years, all of that metadata, all of those subscribers, right? Nations of people by coming to us on our private network.
Anthem on the track. Peace family, peace you and yours, brother Red Pill, AKA Richville, reporting live and direct. Yes, indeed, I am here to let the family know and to inform y'all, if you're not informed already, that YouTube terminated Know the Ledge Media. I'm getting a lot of inboxes, phone calls, text messages. They're like, yo, what happened to... Yeah, well, they made a move, and we didn't make it public like that because we were in litigation. We have a class action suit that we are going to pursue. We'll fill you in on that on a later date. But for now, we're in the process of removing all of our content off of YouTube because the algorithm is kind of going crazy right now. And we're building a standalone app, our own streaming platform. In the meantime, we're asking all of our supporters and our members to come over to Patreon. Patreon.com/RedPillar. This is a page I started in 2016. And we are committed to building up a membership. We are committed to being up a network. And it's going to start over there at Patreon. Me and Boot, we always have events. So Melanin Monday, Third Eye Thursdays, access there. We have a masterclass every month, at least two of them. You get it over there. We also have dailies. You have access to the Discord, and there's a whole bunch of perks that come with every tier. But it's free for every single person if you feel that you just want to be in the building. But if you want them perks, then you become one of those tiers from Copper all the way up to Citrine.
So are we on the air? Are we on the air?
Bang, 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 bang. Yeah.
Patreon.com/RedPillar. Red Pillar. I look forward to seeing all of you beautiful people pull up over there and joining us. We're over 1,000 deep over on Patreon. My goal is 100,000. I need 100,000 of the family members over there so we can make world history. I promise you. I promise you. Tomorrow on Melanin Monday, we're going to start the rollout of the Facts 24, and we'll begin to have that conversation on how 100,000, or rather 144,000, are going to be able to change the world in ways that, you know, I'm telling you, 2024, this leap year, this is a wild card year. This is the now or the never, but this is definitely a quantum leap year, henceforth while we're in the quantum quickening. Henceforth, why time is moving so fast. Time is actually moving quicker. However, things are actually manifesting quicker. You just can't put shit down and be like, yo, I'm going to come back to it in another day. No, it's moving so fast and the AI is so advanced and the tools are here to make you knock shit out later, says who? Like, that's not the time we in right now. And I'm not preaching to the choir because I don't do it. But the waking up mad early is the cheat code. That's how you get the best out of this new paradigm that we're in. The 3 a.m., 4 a.m. wake-up calls, y'all living in a different existence than people waking up at 12. It's just simple logic. It's like going to the movies. The movies, not even before, 3 a.m., the serenity and the quietness of the mind, 4 a.m., and you've accomplished some things that you never accomplished when you wake up at 10 or 9 or noon.
Wow.
By 12, by noon, you already went through a whole, you already experienced a whole day, right? Them 6 hours, I know people get to big bags at that time. How is that? Why is that? Why that is? Worm. If somebody wakes up before you, they got one up on you.
That's true.
Yeah. So the solution that we found to all of this is to create a program where we literally are locked in to a content house, and the rules of this content house is similar to the rules of being locked up, right? Because what people lack is the discipline. Whatever studies have shown, and 9 out of 10 inmates have also admitted, that when niggas get locked up, they turn into geniuses. Why is that?
No distractions.
No distractions, right?
Right.
They start drawing wild.
Less distractions.
Right. You know what I'm saying? You have our comic books like Stan Lee. But Stan G had 20 years because he stood over somebody and with whatever awakening that people behind those walls go through, they're going through their what they call college. Because they're learning something. Only a handful of them come home dumb as a doornail. They're learning something. And as a matter of fact, these days, these are some different type of, 13th Amendment citizens. They got pads and tablets and phones. They day trading.
Forex.
4X in it. They're waking up at what? 4 a.m. And what they doing?
In the studio.
In the stool. On band lab. On a phone. Right? Uploading shit to SoundCloud. They are day trading. They invest the money listening to him 500 in them or whoever these influencers are. They right. Signing up to courses and sharing courses. Especially in the feds. Where it's not war going on like that. It's a little more laid back, and it's a lot of money in there, right? That's what they're doing. And I'm not going to tell everybody's business like that because that's not my business. Right. But that's what I could show you. I could show you the articles and some of the stories about how people are having, they're having these quote unquote success stories behind the wall, because guess what? We live in this world right now where negatives are positives and positives are negatives. It's like a bizarro world because what you thought was a negative, people are turning that into a positive.
Facts.
So the negative is that they sat somebody down and took them off the street and stopped them from getting their shit peeled back or whatever comes with these, with these streets, right? And they sat him down for 3, 4, 5, maybe 30 years. Because there's people coming back from 30 years. I'm meeting people that was like, yo, I just did 25. I'm like, you look 25. What are you talking about? How? No, for real, bro. I just met somebody. I ain't gonna put his name out there, but his cousin is a famous rapper. Bro looked like he's about 30, the oldest. He was like, yeah, I just did 25.
Wow.
So.
You know what they say?
Huh?
Black don't crack.
Black don't crack, bro. You know what I'm talking about? Black don't crack. Like, there's a lot of. Man. People. Like, I brought Henrietta Lacks up. Like, she's Henrietta not an Lacks. Isolated.
Shout out to Henrietta
Lacks. Yeah, shout out to her. I hope some. They got a lot of AI with bio these days. I hope they really speed it up and show that she is not alone. There is so many people with that Immortal Gene and what was signing up to the Patreon. I appreciate that. That's
definitely
what's up.
Sign up to the Patreon. Definitely worth it.
Right. If I have any mods in the building, we're going to be collecting mods. Yes. Let me just say, we'll have our stated. We are going to be in this studio for about a month. I'm not coming outside. I have a goal to get 100,000 subscribers, right? On the streaming platform, okay? YouTube, we could run it up. But in the streaming world, we hitting 100,000 and then we going all the way up to 1 million. You feel me? This is going to be one of the biggest platforms for our demographics. We have multiple niches. We're not stuck in one place. Right, my good brother? Right,
multiple niches? Yeah.
Multiple niches.
We have a store. We have apparel in the store.
Yes.
I got my line. Red had his line.
Yes. You know,
Blue Pill got shoes.
Yes.
Gold Water.
Yes. So, yo, could they go to your page real quick? Could we go to athletics?
And go to athletics.com. Yeah,
get a quick commercial.
And y'all hit us in a DM.
That's right. We ship outside the Antarctica wall and whatnot. That's right. Nationwide.
Planetary.
We
ship to Mars.
Yes, outside. The
gram would probably be better.
Yeah, go to Instagram. Y'all give it up to our peoples, Haiti in the back, the engineer who making all of this possible, man. Give them your Cash App, too. You know what I mean? My people are very generous, and they're giving people. They respect hard work and whatnot. You've been working very hard making sure this thing is professionally broadcasted and whatnot. That's very important. Media is number one in the war chest. Understand that. Media is number one.
Bang, bang.
To this day.
Media. Medea.
To this day.
Wouldn't be possible.
Medea, right.
To Medea, this day.
Before Tyler Perry. Right. Not to be on some Tyler Perry jokey shit. Medea before Tyler Perry. Because Tyler Perry.
Oh, it's AFR. It's AFR.
AFR?
AFR.
Right there. Yes. And Medea is Roman. And it's very important that we have outlets, right? To get real media from real people doing real things. It's really about that life. You know what I mean? Yeah, who you get your media from is of utmost importance. What happened to all of everybody's heroes? What happened to all of these talking heads that they be seeing on these TV channels that they swore was the second or third coming or something? The minute they get fired, where's the fire? How you gonna get fired and lose your fire? It don't make no sense.
Have a spark to begin with.
Right. You didn't have the spark to begin with. Your spark, they paid for your spark. Your spark was spark. Hold on.
You can go back to
speaking
the top.
Of spark. Yeah.
Bang,
hold on.
Bang.
Speaking
bang,
of spark.
Bang.
Speaking of spark.
Let's play the first one.
Speaking of spark. This is.
Represents a virtue of these ancestors that resonate.
Let me know if y'all can hear that.
That's why we call ourselves the original team sport, and we are all a part of this league. So which team are you? To find out, click the link in the bio for more information and to purchase. Also, sign up for our mailing list. We have free giveaways weekly. Athletics is a clothing brand that incorporates black history into sports theme. Figures such as Nat Turner, Harriet Tubman, and Marcus Garvey are some of the many influences of our designs. Each team represents a virtue of these ancestors that resonates with us.
Yo, this is Jefferson from Star Status. We got a market-wide sale about to pop off next week. Y'all need to come. You get some fresh gear. You get your Zodiac packs.
Yeah,
you get
right
your hat. All that. You know what I'm saying? It's never going to be on sale again. So you need to come through and get your market-wide sale. Everything's on sale. What you waiting on? Yo,
this is Jefferson from Star Status.
Up to 30% off on selected items.
I'm feeling beautiful,
Oh, it's still in the draft. Well, it's in the story, though. Yeah, hit the story. Then click on that right there.
Type. Get a wet on the news type. Sipping, drinking, don't screw type. Just say, run through crew type. I got a bad bitch at home, voodoo type. Take down, make it stay, you don't start a group type. That's some deep. I just thought you knew type. I just treat doctor, don't just usually do this type. Pockets red, all blue type. Bunch of rich. Atlanta, a little like T, turn the type. I'm counting, bro, knocking jobs, lose type.
Counseling
her, kick her out of school type. A silent hitter, how'd you keep cool with you? A solid count dog, fool type.
Moving
through the city with your boo type.
She's
ready to suck it up like a suit type.
Going against that, fell out.
Yeah, yeah. Put up, I don't hang with rats, that's some new type.
I just wanna rock. I just wanna. I just wanna rock. Body out of y'all. Shorty got that body out of y'all. Hit it once. No time. Set up for.
That's fire.
April 13th and 14th. Vegan. Vegan Fest. Those jackets are on sale right now as well at the store. Any of them I have left. It's limited sizes. They're going kind of fast.
Yes, yes.
I mean, relax, it's the GOAT. Mind my black on business. Yeah, we have those sweatshirts available at the store on the website, brownery.net. My TikTok shop, or DM me, and I'll get it to you. Ship nationwide. We also have the Soldier Culture shirts, t-shirts, and hoodies. Make Gaza Great Again, Palestine. Tees.
The commercial's over.
Commercial never over.
Or never over. Never over.
But nah, I'm Gucci. It's about 3 a.m. Damn near.
Yes, yes, yes.
They got people waking up right now.
That's a beautiful
thing. They groggling in their bed. We about to go to bed.
That's how it be, though. You know, we live in parallel universes. I always said when it's 4:44 a.m. in Atlanta, it's 1:44 a.m. in L.A. Somebody's going to sleep while somebody is waking up. That just goes to show you that we live in a parallel unit. We live in different worlds. Mm-hmm. Literally, somebody's going to sleep and it's Monday night. And then right there at the same time, like I could be live at 4:44 a.m. in the A or in New York, mm-hmm. right? and I'm getting up and it's Tuesday and I got Tuesday's energy on me and I'm thinking Tuesday, like I'm on Thor's, I'm on Tuesday, and you know, but somebody's on after club 1:44 a.m. smoking some kush, about to smack bellies with, you know what I mean?
Splash with a shorty.
Splashington. Right? On Monday night, though.
Monday night, Raw.
Hey.
He about to get this work. He about to get this.
Hey, yeah. There's
definitely people in different time zones. Different zones, worlds.
Worlds. Somebody could be standing right next to you and be in a whole nother timeline. I be telling niggas we're not on the same eye line. We're not even in the same timeline. Like, I'm standing next to you, but my timeline is crazy. Imagine when I turn on my Ray-Bans and you can see me live. My whole timeline and shit that I'm experiencing is crazy. I don't know if you'll ever experience anything like that in one day, let alone all of the days. Everybody not set up like that. So your experience is unique to you. You should be very... I'm cocksure about my experiences, and you know what I do is, you know, I call upon the force to be with me. Yeah. Fight the force, young Anakin, and you shall too. May the force be with you. And with that being said, we will see you in Melanin. Stay tuned. And look for us in KTL Studios. Loving the lights. New music coming out. We might debut something tomorrow. Who knows? Loving light. All right? Hit up the Cash App. Show love to independent media. Peace. Yeah.
To this day.
Bang, bang, bang.
Bring that back.
You don't find that suspicious.
You gonna get this work. You gonna get this work. Nigga. You gonna get this work.
To this day.
You gonna get this work, nigga.
To this day.
I'm not.
To this day. To this day.
Lift every voice without lifting a thing. The baby was born to give a sing. Ancient history happened, mystery cracking. It's the elitists attacking the fetus. They packing the seats up, cracking the seats.
Not in the back, make green, not in the back.
it's me. Popping up here in a Holy Ghost 3. That was a beat, beat up a cheat. A home on my beast on the road, on my creek. You don't believe, don't speak, that's a cold in the street.
If I take the breath, God gave you the breathe. Remove the air from the wind and the breeze. Superman to turn to Christopher Reeve. My engine is deep. I'm trying to blood, you got in you that bleeds. Chop the tree of knowledge down to pick up the leaves. Superman to turn to Christopher Reeve. My engine is deep.
It would appear as if I was a sick individual. You know, I'm gifted in the fact that I can actually interact. Family love in this state is definitely your conduit, your transmission system. It's not me. You know what I mean? I've equipped in my mind with the algorithm, so by learning words, the more availability you have to your expression, the more is which is going to be related in a sense. Just like if you got the best internet connection in the world. You feel me? The only way you can get that is by allowing yourself to be that, man. You got to be open.
Go so deep.
Don't know me no more, ego so free. Don't know evil, no evil, no me.
Go so deep.
Yeah.
My little magic friend.
Nah, I'm
the back of skin and casted in. The voice you're hearing on the track is him.
Big T. Big T, hit me up on the email. I got you, my brother. Great Big T. Yeah, we in production.
So before they bring assassins in and put me in a casket, let me grab a pen. Slice wrist, jab it in, plug it in the main vein, and fill it with my blood intravenously. Write my life story. Okay. End it with a dot from the last drop of blood I have to bleed in me. Dead, but I'm resurrected when you're reading me. I put me in ink, corpse got a deity. Yeah, elevation of the Kundalini. If I make it up to heaven's gates, I'ma do graffiti. I don't care if you was Mussolini. I let an entity enemy, how could an enemy crew defeat me? You don't got the visuals to see me. I can see better in 4D than you do in 3D. I need a queen if I'ma ever be truly kingly. She put the rubber on me, I'ma bust out, I'm a super genie. Wrote this with a ghost talking to me that I met when I was doing Ouija.
Melanin Mondays tomorrow. We back. Melanin Mondays tomorrow. It's gonna be a classic. I promise you. Make sure y'all tell a friend. Make sure y'all subscribe. 100,000 subscribers. That's the goal.
What topics we covering tomorrow?
Facts 24. Food, the art, the clothes, the tech, the shelter. Yeah, 24. It's time for this initiative to pick up. You know, it's a lot of campaigning taking place from these political parties, but we need solutions that come from the body politic of the people that we know in our community, our networks and whatnot. I'm not waiting for Joe Biden or Donald Trump
to come up with any solutions or any type of plans, waiting for them. Yeah, I'm not giving none of that no energy. So, Facts Initiative, we have something, a real special presentation. That's tomorrow, right here. All right, we'll see you at the IRL later on, maybe a month from now, 30 days. But right now we're in the studio doing this studio production work. So we're inside doing this work, you know what I mean? We'll see you outside, right?
Yeah.
Maybe in 30 days.
30 days. So you can see me outside.
Yeah, he's at the New Black Wall Street.
I'll be outside Wednesday through Sunday at Black Wall Street.
That's right.
And you might occasionally, run into Rich Phil as well. If your luck is right. If your luck is right.
A lot of things to talk about. So, like we were saying, Happy New Year's to everybody. This is the beginning of, a New Year's. I celebrate this new year, this new moon, this new year, this new energy, this new opportunity that's coming on April 8th with this, eclipse. I don't plan on staring at the eclipse, right? I don't plan on participating in observing it. However, this April 8th eclipse is going to be a book ending of an epoch, of a time period, 22 was as well, right? We're coming to book ends, closures, right? And they said this is the ending. This will usher in the beginning of the Aquarian Age. That would be the official ushering in, the X that's going across America, okay? And touching Ohio and other places. So, me and Al Kibalon on the 7th, the day before, we will be on Zoom conducting a very thorough presentation entitled Vulture Culture. The vultures are up 100 right now. Shout out to the vultures. Shout out to Ye, Cardi. Shout out to all of the people who are tapping into that anti-establishment. The Travis, that's a whole energy taking place. It's a whole mind state. It's a whole side, so there's sides right now. And it went from just one artist, and now it's seeming like the whole industry is split like that Red Sea, right? But you have a false prophet, and then you have a false messiah, and then you have a real messiah.
Then you have an antichrist.
Then you have a Christ, and then you have an antichrist, right? The Book of Clarence and whatnot, the twin. You have to know what you're looking at. So this Hebrew Israelite, Kendrick Lamar, is going to talk to this brother who is considered to be the descendants of the identity stealers or the identity takers, right? Mm-hmm. These people from the Caucasus Mountains, who are not traditionally part of that lineage. So Kendrick Lamar, who is a well-researched young man and is not afraid to hold his tongue to speak about worldly events, he'll talk to that boy. That boy doesn't speak about worldly events. That's not what he's known for. So his superpower, which is sassy aggressiveness. Nigga hits like Jake Paul with the sassy aggressiveness. He's the Jake Paul of sassy aggressiveness, right? It's those underdogs. Somebody broke it down for me the other day when I was talking favorably about Blurs. And they were like, yeah, we hear that shit you saying about the Blurs, but it's really the Misfits. The Blurs ain't active. The Blurs don't pop out. The Blurs ain't hip to the hop. They're not the ones that move the goalposts. Jermaine Dupri didn't do this. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. The Blurs are not the ones. It's the Misfits. Niggas with face tats. Like, it's the Misfits of science, it's the Misfits. They're the ones who push the niggas, you know what I mean? It was the Misfits, and they do get them mixed up, they do get them confused. I identify as a Misfit, you know what I'm talking about? One of my favorite shows was Misfits of Science when I was growing up. You young buckaroos don't know nothing about that, you know?
Mr. Wizard. I used to like Mr. Wizard.
Facts. Remember Manimal?
Manimal was crazy.
Crazy. Yeah, man. So we are not the same. And there's nothing wrong with that. We just got to pay homage to that. We are not the same, bro. And being not the same comes with advantages. Imagine being in a movie and you came in 3 hours in and you gonna tell the person who was there before the movie even started about the movie. There should be a rule against that. But that's the internet. You know what I mean? And that's what free speech gets you. We don't come from free speech. We came from your speech was restricted for reasons that dealt with order and law. Because coming up, if somebody, let me just ask you, anybody in the room, when you was coming up, if somebody was listening to Louis Farrakhan speak, right, and they just wanted to get up and say what people in comment sections or what people be saying or to other people on the internet, no matter who they are, they could be somebody of the highest of highest stature. If somebody got up and said that in person, right, like back in the days, we talking about like the 80s, what would happen to them in real life, IRL?
They get smashed.
Super smashed, though, right?
They okay. Get snatched up out right. of that. They get stumped out
right.
by the people.
Right. Early world star before and, world star.
When the security,
halal world
when
star.
Security gets over there.
Right. And then when security, they gonna press on you. It's a toss up.
Yeah. They're getting tossed out after you're getting some bumps and
bruises. Getting 86.
It's not happening. So, yeah, the comment section does give people some more heart. You know,
I'm just saying that times, fake heart, sassy heart, right? Sassy heart, sassy aggressiveness, right? Almost like a cancer, y'all, for real, like a virus. The sassy aggressives, they come from the culmination of what took place in the Zest Fest. Now they talk about the Greek Fest, right? And they talk about the Freaknik. Yes, but the Zest Fest. Nobody talks about what that created. But that's a whole nother show. But listen, you know, it's definitely, you know, worth noting. It's definitely worth noting.
Right. Shout out to Russia.
Shout out to Russia. They outlawed it as a terrorist organization. Just really for, like, sit back for... You know,
Klan.
With like when you smoke the weed and you get those thoughts, just let that marinate after the show is over. Give it some thought about what Russia's looking like and what's the possibility of how many people that look like us are going to go back to Russia. When people go back to Russia, symbolically what that means is a return of a certain type of empire, a certain type of, you know, existence, Tartarians. That's what it means symbolically. When I see the passport bros, I don't look at it from the place of the Kevin Samuels red pill, right? This red pill thing took over the world. And people be like, you know, nobody says, yo, why are you Rich Phil right now? People understand it. Like, right. Fam, I endured with this red pill thing, like, They did woke and some other, but they did this red pill shit dirty.
Yeah.
If you want to talk about brand damage, Candace Owens came out when she started out. Her name was Red Pill Black. Van Lathan had the Red Pill podcast. Incels and people running around pre Kevin Samuels was the Red Pill community and the shit coming out of. Wow, I don't like red pill. Like, I don't like them either. The right. fuck? Which I get
one?
It.
Like, which one?
Which one, though? Which one? You don't even know. Be like, I heard so many bad things about red pill because you be on the herbal Zannies. Yeah, niggas be on, shrooms and echinacea. Yeah, they be on shrooms and fermented echinacea. You know what I'm saying?
Lavender.
You know, lavender. You know how niggas be... These niggas come from the planet Ritz. Or they come from these other constellations and
the barrel.
Yeah, they do a lot of mixing of things. So they come up with concoctions. So you got the shrooms with the hoppe with a little bit of grabber.
Grabber gang.
Yeah.
Don't forget the grabber gang.
Don't forget the grab with the punch, right? The and the yeah. Mixed with the ayahuasca,
ooh.
with a little bit of sea moss in it.
Sea moss
for the because it holds, it bonds in the 92.
I suggest you drip a gold water.
Full download lives and whatnot based off of what happens after that concoction enters their bloodstream. That's what we're dealing with. That level of, you know what I mean? But when you have a breakthrough, when you hit one, you hit one. You know what I'm talking about? When you score, you score. But it's a lot of people just experimenting with any and all everything these days. And it's like, how the hell do you trust anything that you hear? What the fuck? Like, I just said I don't want no new friends. Oh, there's Bigo consciousness. There's TikTok consciousness. Yo, consciousness looks different in different places. What's true. Fucking with that, though?
It's true.
Right? What's fucking with? We seen where it started.
Yeah.
Many of us was like, because when it started on 2/5, it didn't exist other places.
Right.
So it's hard to have any conversation with anybody that doesn't really come from that vantage point or see it like certain things. Vantage point is important. So it's like, fam, I was there the day before the shit started. So I must have been, either I must have been mad lucky or, nigga, we started the shit. I got letters that I wrote A.A. Rashid. It's doing 10 years in a pokey in a Bing. And I ain't talking about Microsoft, nigga. He was in a Bing. Ching Bing. Shout out to Ching Bing.
You don't find that suspicious.
Shout out to Ching Bing.
You don't find that suspicious.
And in 2003,
you don't find that suspicious.
I'm writing letters and I'm like, yo, I had a vision and a dream that this conscious shit that we on is going to be adopted by mad young people. We're going to be hopping out of forums like Meeching Them. I was already talking about Meeching Them in the letter. Like, yo, I see us, but we're going to be doing it from books and herbs. And I'm like, yo, that's crazy, right? But I'm saying, I see it. We're going to be lit off of just being smart, bro. Imagine that. We won't have to be buried alive no more. I wrote it. So the life that I'm existing in my vantage point and the way that I see this thing, like the Twin Pillars is not, we didn't just run around and grab a name that was on. Niggas just start pulling different names out of a hat. All right, let me get the, yeah. Let's see, open it up. Like the boy, like the alright. I'm a Jesuit. Alright. He's a Jeremiah. Jeremiah. Alright, Jeremiah Bey, Mustafa El Orangutan, Osiris. Like El Hodge Orangutan. Like, what are y'all out here doing? Niggas is having So it's like it's drastically has changed.
Yeah, people just waking up. Yesterday.
So there should
just
be...
Just the stuff is after right. Savvy going down the rabbit hole. What?
Like, oh, my goodness.
Religion?
You mean to tell me the carrot wasn't real?
Easter?
What?
Oh, no.
He said what?
So they got people just waking up.
So imagine going to do a heart surgery, and as you're trying to get into surgery, people keep pulling you to talk to you. That's what this is in a nutshell. You're going to do heart surgery, but the people in the hospital is fanned out and they stopping you everywhere you go. But while you trying to do the surgery, to ask you questions about shit that they should have learned at the front desk before they even got into the hospital. So because this is a free for all and everybody is let in and all you got to have is a septum ring, you know what I mean? There's no standards. There's no orientation. There's no concentrated, you know, type of structure whatsoever. There's just rumors, recommendations, and following algorithms and shit like that. That's really what it is. And then it's a lot of waving of bandwagons and you know, and fucking trains that y'all get ran on and run. Hold on. The conscious IRMTA train.
It's just like real life.
It's just like real life.
It is real life.
Real life.
But it's like every other sector. You're going to have your messy folks. You're going to have your cool folks.
It's life.
You're going to have your money makers. It's going to be going on all in the mix, intertangled with the other side. So everybody got their sector within, they making money and moving, or they like to hang with. But right. They also got to deal with the world as a whole.
Right. So, people come out to play, you know, but this is a competition sport unlike anything that you've ever seen in your life.
Because it is your life.
This is the streets on a level that y'all can't even conceive, because imagine American Gods or something, or imagine the Watchmen. Imagine street people with powers. That's really what y'all dealing with. Y'all dealing with street people with kind of like superpowers in a sense. You might not derogatory though, and I'm not claiming to be something of a lower frequency. I'm not proud, and I'm not one of those people that try to wear that badge of honor. However, what I'm referring to is the mycelium, the underworld, the undergirding of things, the dark, the shadow, right? Which is not a bad thing. That mycelium is not a negative. The DNA is not a negative. The fertilizer is not a negative, right? These are mandatory. This is foundation. It's not what's on top. It's what's underneath. Scorpions and our energy and our nature, we are the underworld, underneath, undergirdings, underbellies. We understand all of that. We empowered. We are empowered by all of that unapologetically. You feel me? We are the ones that are going to walk you through the shadow, walk you through the darkness, shine the light on the things that need to be shined on. And that's something that we're successfully. I started talking about Playboi Carti how long ago? A minute ago. I started talking about Trav. Now, people under, yo, Red, I didn't know. Yeah, of course. But when it's told to you, it's a pearl that got pitched. Right. You didn't respect it because I was on a camera phone. But we moving forward.
Days is over, hover.
You know what I'm talking about? Days is over, hover. You know, we on a different type of time. And like I said, you know, it's a new level right now. This ain't no shoestring budget. This ain't no shoestring budget. We lit. You know what I'm talking about? This is just one sequence. It's levels to this shit right here. You know, if you got these right here, we could take you into the metaverse. If you want to take it on VR, if you want to go AR, you know what I mean? Like, we could take it all kind of places. We could do location. Like, we're going to be going live from the streets. It's a red and a blue thing, and we campaigning. Facts 24, red and the blue. You know what I mean? State to state, 144,000. You feel me? 144,000.
Country to country.
Right, country to country. That 144,000, I'll get that in America. And once we get that 144,000, everything is going to change for the better. And that's really not me just saying anything. I'll show you the white paper. I'll be able to discuss everything, and you'll see for yourself, right? It's really easy. It's the easiest thing that you ever have to do. And the thing about technology, I'm not wasting my time when propaganda is 90% of war and we at war. I'm not, you know what I mean? I can't exert any type of energy to try to convince anybody of anything. And we live in a dream of pillar prophecies. We live in a sea of pillar prophecies. And there's been no retribution, no contributions, nothing but contempt. You know what I mean? Nothing but contempt and backbiting. You know, nothing but contempt and all kind of, you know, what we would call untrustworthy behavior from people that we had close to us and around us. But, you know, in the spirit of this moon, we just want to say, bro, we don't trust you.
We gonna get this work.
Bang. We don't trust you. And everybody can't make it. You know?
Everybody can't go. Everybody can't make it.
everybody can't do it. A lot of people got a lot of fake on them. You know? And this thing is like a rest haven, and it got to change from that. Because we have to move like politicians, and we got to move like a body politic. And when I say politicians, I don't mean in a situation where these are fake politicians who have to live an uppity type of character. No, I'm talking about individuals who are solution-based leaders who can make some things happen, who could direct, who could coach, or who could be quarterbacks, right? Or who could be the defense coordinator who helps out the coach and the quarterback. You don't got to be the front runner. You don't got to be the main player. Manage. You feel me? That's what people, right, they don't understand that. Somebody to manage, bro. So that type of winning team is what I see out here winning right now. It's not, none of this is rocket science. People are not winning because they're not working together. Bottom line, it's as simple as that. We don't have to waste anyone's time. And what I won't do is I'm not wasting none of y'all time. I'm going to be creating some top-tier content. I'm going to travel the world. I'm going to do what I do. You know, I'm going to brand myself into billionaire status. You know, I'm going to get on my Rich Phil shit. And I'm going to let Red Pillar collect his awards and do his tours and all of that. And then Red Pillar surface every now and then. But I refuse. It's plain to see. It is what it is. Like, it is what it is. We are putting classes out there. We doing master classes for free. We do workshops. We do every month. We make sure that we feed the people a lecture. We've been doing this consistently. Brought y'all Chicago crypto. Shout out to the legend. Bitcoin Bully, you know what I'm talking about? One of the best to ever do it. And like I said, we got an announcement to make dealing with some good news that we have for our investors, right? Because there's a difference between a follower and an investor. I want to take y'all out of the follower mentality. I don't accept followers anymore, unfortunately, right? Followers don't serve any purpose. That following shit these days when I'm looking over my shoulder is not a good thing. Let's go from followers to members, and we can have different kind of different conversations, different talk. It's a different cloth when you're a member. And members, members, you can't be a member and be on Instagram. A member has to be, you're dismembered when you're on Instagram. You're on decentralized, right? You're on centralized platform. Then we begin to make moves. Then we can have these conversations about how to win. Then the plan, which is already written out, it's already quote unquote, it's an escrow. Well, it's in a smart contract actually, and it gets activated when we reach our number, right? So the 144 is not a hard number to reach. We could get 144 in subscribers. If I'm going live every day for 3 hours every day, and when I'm not going live, somebody on this network is gonna be going live. But there's so much content already that we have to put on this network and just stream and whatnot. There's lectures that we've done. There's series that we've done. There's workshops that we've done. Right. Like I said, I got Ra Cool workshops, Chicago crypto workshops. I got Ross Ben workshops, Blue Pill workshops, Red Pill workshops. You name it, out there. What? We got content, and content is king. And this information is, you know, it's timeless. It doesn't have an age to it. It's rich in data. It's rich in data. You get your bang for your buck, right? So you got to get your bang. So the future is streaming, and we will be streaming our content. We will be streaming our the content that we have in our archives, as well as newer content. We'll be streaming our daily shows where we deal with hip-hop as the culture, and we also deal with the arts and the sciences. But we also deal with the food, the art, the clothes, the tech, and the shelter. And we also deal with Know the Ledger, which is a part of the technology sector of what we have to represent. All right? Over there, Know the Ledger. All right? Techno Tuesdays and whatnot. And we are bringing back Build and Destroy, which is a monument, which is already an award-winning. It's a classic already. You know what I'm talking about? That's a podcast that we have with Blue Pill, our good brother Malik Deshaun, and our good brother Tariq Bey, a.k.a. Giant. So look out for the premiere of the season two of Build and Destroy. And with that being said, y'all, it's time to sign off. Salute to all of y'all, the supporters who made the upgrade and everything possible. And for all of the supporters of independent media who believe in what it is that we've been doing for 15 years, standing strong, still on the front lines, still putting up points, still scoring like Kobe. You know what I'm talking about? Still cooking in the kitchen. What's consistency worth to you?
Bang, bang.
What's consistency bang, mean bang to you? Find me one that's more consistent. I'll wait.
Watch me work.
Find me one that's consistent.
We gonna get this work.
Who I didn't meet. Find me one. You feel me? So consistency pays off, and it will continue to pay off. And y'all continue to be great. You know what I'm talking about? Y'all continue to be great, and we only accept greatness over here. We not dealing with no pool butts. Sometimes things could get a little too real, you know. But shit is real, man. This is not a game. Life is not a game. And life is not a lecture. Not a noni roll. Haiti, shout out to the family in Haiti, right? Shout out to the family in Haiti. Hopefully we could get some correspondence from the ground in Haiti to let us know what's really going on out there with that revolution that you see taking place. You feel me? With that revolution taking place. April the 7th, Alkibalon 44 and Richfield pulling up. Alkibalon 44 and Richfield pulling up. You know what I'm talking about? And we'll be doing Vulture Culture only on Zoom. All right? Only on Zoom. Okay? That is on Eventbrite. And that is also on KTLUniversity.com. We good? What we doing? Yeah, we done. So love and light to y'all. Melanin Monday tomorrow. We be back. We back. We back, baby. Hold on. We back.